No good news. Aliens are attacking humans. Please leave your house immediately. Oh shit, aliens are attacking the house. Here's a doomsday approach. Well, I'm Ranger Kooky. And this is my bug out day. I got a couple minutes just to get the hell out of there before aliens come here to destroy my home. So, we have to hurry up and bug out. What to do? Come on. You got to get your keys, your phone, your watch, whatever you need, or to get the hell out of here. Alright. So, it's my doomsday prep. I'm going ahead and prep real quick. Alright. The saying today is aliens are coming and ready to destroy all homes, all humans. So, let's get out of here. Are you prepared for doomsday? Let's see how long it takes me to get out of here. The saying the aliens or in New Orleans come across and destroyed all homes. So you must get out your home as soon as possible before the aliens destroy my house and get to my destination of my doomsday thing. Come on, we gotta hurry up and prep. Come on, we gotta go. Okay. Come on, let's go, go. All right, grab the bug out bag. Don't forget your keys. Always remember your keys. All right, a bug out bag. Come on, let's go. The aliens are on the other side of New Orleans, destroying homes. Let's get hurry up and get the hell out of here. All right, got everything. Food, rations, water kit, go. All right, what else we need? We need our keys, our phone. Everything we need right now. Got to bug out, bug out. Come on, let's go. I dread this day. Come on, man. Let's go. There's also saying destroy vehicles. We must hurry up and get the hell out of here.
We know what the intent was, so.
All right. This is very scary. Oh, God. Aliens are attacking us in New Orleans. Don't forget to put your seatbelt on. Because you never know, trying to escape an alien invasion, you can survive if they hit me. Alright, let's go. Shit. Well. Alright. Situation is really going AWOL. Humans are running all over the interstate. I must get to my destination, away from my car, away from my houses, because the aliens are destroying every type of building and vehicle. So I must get away from all those things before I get destroyed. All right. You hear people who are out there on the interstate. They try to find shelter. We got about an hour before the aliens get over here and destroy this side. So come on. Let's get to our camping area. Our bug out place. I finally get to use my bug out bag. The aliens are attacking destroying all homes and vehicles. This, I got about an hour on this side to find shelter away from my vehicle, away from my house. So I'm heading to my bug out or summer camp. Almost there. I should be there within 10 minutes. I'll be at my safe house. The watch that's on this bag, I started at 12 o'clock. You see how long it takes me to get to my bug out place? How long it took me to get everything into my car? You should have a few things, items, for your bug out bag, be ready, and that's all you do is pick up and go. This is a challenge from Ranger Kooky. It's called using your bug out bag in any situation. It could be aliens, like my situation is, zombies, or anything you want to talk about. Crab apocalypse, doesn't matter. I'm gonna do a, this is called a bug out video, and I'm going to tag three people, and they got to do the same thing I'm doing. Here's the rules. You have to leave. You got three choices, three times you can leave. In the evening, or in the morning like I am, or 12 o'clock midnight. That is the challenge. To get your gear, get in your car, and get to your bug out place as fast as you can. Now I got an obstacle course. Alright, I might be able to make this. What you think? No crocodiles? Ooh, that's some deep water too. If I fall, I'm going to be in water. Okay, I didn't expect that. It was summer, supposed to be dried, but oh well. All right, that is my challenge. It's called the bug out bag. Get the hell out of Dodge. See how long it takes you to get to your camping area that you seek shelter from. All right, now I'm almost there to summer camp. This is also an endurance video, thing for me. Trying my endurance to see how well I can handle this bag behind me. It's pretty heavy and big. It's not bulky. I took the swimming suit bag off and put my food pouch at the bottom because it was giving me hell on the side. Now remember, your bug out bag is always give and take in that thing. What you want, what you don't want. You have to figure out what you really want. Need in your bug out bag. Now here's the other rule. You can only challenge, you must tag three people also. I will give the rules out again after I get my base. You must tag three people also, and they must have a bug out bag. If they don't have a bug out bag, you cannot challenge them. You can ask them if they have one. At the end of this video, I'm gonna explain the rules again and who I'm challenging to do this challenge. All right, I could go across that. See, that's my base. I gotta get across. And across that water right there, I take my shoes off, my socks. That was gonna be cold. Or I could try the trail. All right, let's go to the trail. The rules are simple for this challenge. I want to see you use your bug out bag. I mean, we have them, let's use them. I want to see how well you use your bug out bag to get to your destination. And this is where I have to go down, this, to get across that log of fire and death to get to my camp. I'll probably have a better chance going across the water area. In this area. See, my challenge is very, I got about 100 something pounds on my back. I gotta cross all this or go across the water so I can get wet or stay dry. It's not winter, so I can get wet and should have no problem. It's a nice summer. Look at that. Okay, we got choices, go down or go through the water. I'm thinking about going through the water. I hope it's not too deep. Yeah, this bag weighs about 100 pounds, especially with the food in it. Because you want food to last longer than 3 or 4 days. And that's the other thing. If you do, you have to bring food that lasts at least 7 days. I don't care what kind of food, as long as it's some type of food, and you gotta last 7 days with that food. You don't have to stay in the camp area for 7 days unless you got time. I don't have time. It's just a scenario. That's all I'm doing. It's a scenario. All right. Look at my white legs. Hoo-wee. Hoo-wee. Ooh, wee. All right, I'm gonna cross the water. Damn it! Voila. I was supposed to have done this yesterday. But somebody called me at work and they needed more help at work. Oh, there goes my pants. Oh, bitch. That's all right, they're dry. That's what these scenarios are for. All right, I'm across. Let's get to it. All right. So what I want to do is hurry up and get my base going. This is the heaviest and hardest part. Going up this mountain. Couple of reasons why I didn't take all the branches out. We can get up this thing. Whew. All right, I'm at base. Alright, how do they get this thing off? Alright. All right, I'm at my base camp or summer camp. Look at my situation, what we got. All right. All right, we are here. So, that was an endurance there, going up that hill. Plus, it's not that high. That's why I choose to, I'll go ahead and knock this out. Oh, man. All right. Alright, I'm at my summer camp. I know you can barely see, but I'm out here. Alright, I'm gonna catch my breath, check my time. Let's go ahead and check my time now. It took me 35 minutes to get my bag, get in my car, go. Get where I need to go. Here's my area where I will survive to the alien invasion's over with. And that's my scenario. I'm gonna open my bags and put my stuff out, cut some more tree limbs, or I could wait till Donny come out here and pit my camp. But here's the scenario. Doesn't matter what kind of scenario it is, as long as it's some type of scenario, to grab your bug out bag, run out your house within so many minutes to get to your camping area or your survival area, get there and put your stuff out, time it, start your clock at 12 o'clock and time it, see how long it takes. Two, I'm gonna tag three people. And those people must have a bug out bag. If you go through their videos and find out if they had a bug out bag, you can challenge them. Three, you gotta have or show food that is gonna be 7 days or more. I don't care about your gear. I just wanna see your food. How long? It has to be 7 days of food to survive. I thought I had another one. You know, it's getting daylight. It's beautiful out here during the night and day. I'm going to challenge three people. You have to have food for 7 days or more. And the people I challenge had to have a bug out bag. Got to use it. Have a scenario about what kind of scenario. Does as long as you use your bug out bag in some type of scenario. Challenge three people, food for 7 days. They must have a bug out bag. And see how long it take you to get to your survival camping area with your full gear. Because the next video you'll see will have everything out, showing you everything what I have. And I added some stuff to it. All right, let me let you go and let me take. All right, what I want to do is try to get my stuff unpacked since I got more daylight now, so I can see better. What I want to do is just start getting my stuff off the ground. Having wet stuff is not a good picnic to have. Now, I can get SS to any one of these bags and within no time. Got my cook kit, my canteen, some water pouches, some rope, I already showed you what's in this bag, so I'm repeating myself. Alright, what I want to do is just get everything off the ground and maybe cover it. Especially my food. You don't want the food on the ground because the ants are eating. Yeah, now I have a choice. I can do both. I can sleep in my hammock. Or I can sleep in my tent. I can make this a bush chair. I can use this as a net to catch fish in that bayou we just passed. So I have choices with this net. Remember, multiple use. I can got three with this. Fishnet, hammock, and bush chair. But right now, I can use it to sleep in. So, let's get that out. Plus, the floor here is like a slant. Unless I build it up with that bucket I have out here, build the sand up, which I did over here when I was camping out here with my friend Andrew, or I could just get in the hammock. I don't want to get in the hammock. I think it'd be easier. That's a bad idea. If you need your bag, you need to run. raise it up a little bit more. That should be good for my hammock situation. I can always make it a little higher on this side if I want. Now the zip cord. I got my cordage, my thing. Now I have to get my tarp up. Thank you, Josh. This is a good kit. I'm glad you thought of it. I think I got the wrong one, the wrong spot. You can always solve a problem if you have a problem when you're in the woods. Since I can't put it in the hammock, I can put it underneath the hammock. I had to tie that off. Try to get in there with that in the middle. Now that would keep me warm at night. Because the minute I put weight in it, I will lay in that perfectly. I noticed I need more 550 cord. That's why I have always carry extra on my thing. If I had to bug out, I can grab this in my tent. I'm good to go for the next round. And try to grab my food, but you can't. That's why you should have multiple places with buckets with food in it, like I do. See, there's a bucket right there. Alright. Now, just a little go over. Now, I can make it, I can open these up to have more airflow. Depends on the weather and the temperature. But right now, it might be just as good as like this. And I have one trowel. This will cover me up at night. Now, I'm just going to go ahead and get in here real quick just to see what it's all about. I do need to tie my tarp up. The other things, I forgot to mention, you got to show every day how to use your equipment while you're out here. All right, you got to leave at midnight, morning, or evening. You must have a scenario. You must tag three people that has a bug out bag. And you got to show everybody how to use your equipment. All right. See, I can stick this out, open my tarps, but I'm going to leave it like it is. Okay, what else we got? Basically, that's all I got, but I'm out here and I gotta keep my firewood dry. So once I establish an area for firewood, I should cover it up as immediately as I can. That's why I bring two garbage bags, because you never know what you can use with these garbage bags. Alright. I'm going to show you how I use them. The Kooky way. And all the stuff. You know one thing I forgot to grab? It's very important to do this, and I want you to do this like it's real. Because when you do it like it's real, you forget to leave stuff. You will leave stuff. You know what I left? My neck knife. But I do have knives here. But that neck knife would have been easy. It's right there on my neck. I could have grabbed it and used it. Now I have to go through a bag and find a knife. All right. What you want to do to protect your firewood after you establish some firewood, you want to protect that firewood at all costs, because that's your lifeline. Without firewood, or gas like I have, or alcohol burner, you need fire to boil water, cook food. So remember, I got enough food for 7 days. That's the scenario. I want to see the food in your bug out bag of 7 days or more. I don't care what kind of food, as long as it's 7 days or more. You can stay out here for 7 days. I cannot. I gotta work. So all right, what you want to do is cut the top off your bag so it opens up like so. Let's go on. All right, now I only got one camera left. That sucks. What you want to do is take a big stick and place it like so on one side, and place another stick like so. Now that would protect majority of your wood. Now, I could open it up and cover the whole thing, but I want that weight. The weight of the two sticks will hold that in place. You know, I got a lot of firewood in the middle of that protective. This damn camera. Why? All right. So take that bag and open it up as much as you can. Now. I'm gonna put up my stuff, whatever I'm not using. I got my hammock out. Now there's multiple ways of making this work. I could have slept on the floor, you know, on the ground. I could have used my tent, but I choose the hammock system. Now, I might have to organize this. But there you go. And the rest is just firewood, and let's see if I can find some dry wood. That's all wet. I can't use it. So I put it on this thing with bread rack. See the bread racks? And I'll see if I can dry out my wood over time. I got a cover over it this time. It might dry out. I can use this TP to cover my firewood with bags, but I don't want to be seen out here. And I kind of fixed up my camping area, you know, got all the sticks up, and that's about it. I'm ready to stay out here for a night or two, if I could, but I can't, but I can stay out here. Oh, we'll put this up before it gets all damp, so you want to put that in your hammock, keep it dry. And the rest is it. I got the fire kit, the radio, cook kit, and I got my machete, my saw, my multi-tool, I got everything I showed you in my bug out bag, but I'm using it. All right, I think I'm gonna end up the video of my bug out. And say that is it. And oh yeah, I want to show you. I got my stuff from Tom. So while I'm out here, I can sit. This is so lightweight. I have a bush chair. This is one with the four sticks. I think it's too big, but oh well. I have my cot. See, I can also, instead of using the hammock or the tent, I can use this cot. Big glass sticks I have to make. Then I have my normal bush chair, which is also very long. But Tom made all these things for me. Thank you, Tom. I hope you enjoy my bug out. Get out the house bug out. And I want to save some battery juice for other projects. All right, well, I'm going to let you go. All right, here's the second option I have. Come up some. The second option is to use the silver lining, the stakes. If I'm not mistaken, I'm supposed to stake out the tarp and the bottom layer together. So I have two options. I can use my hammock, or I use the system that Josh had created, which is the little teepee thing here. I think I got my line too high. Then again, I can tie a rope here or bring my line down. There we go. This is the second option I can use. Like that. And I guess you're supposed to get inside. I guess. Listen to me. And that's all I have to do is grab my blanket, throw it in there, lay across the insulated tarp, and that protect me. I know it's a sloppy job. I'm just trying to hurry up and do some stuff out here. But basically, that's how that system works. And you already seen my tent, so I'll have to put out the tent. But that's the second system I have out here. I have three systems: the hammock with the tarps, or the tent, or that, whatever you want to call that, TP thing. All right, I'm Ranger Kooky. See you next time. Here's something you might not know. Let's say you need to go, and you got an established campsite like this one. This is my summer camp. Let's take a look at it again. Now, this is a established campsite. But when you do your business, make sure you'll go about at least 50 feet away from your camp or more. Why? Why you should use the bathroom 40 feet or 50 feet away. Because what happens, flies land on your estimates if you don't bury it. So always bury your estimates. If you don't bury it, flies can land on it. Then they'll fly into your campsite and land on your food. Can get you sick. So, if you're in a survival situation, never, never lay an egg somewhere without covering it. Always cover your eggs, if you know what I mean, your estimate. Because a fly can land on it, then fly into your camp and lay on your food, then can get you sick. And if you're in a survival situation, you don't want that. So, take tip number 252-100-110-10-10-5-5-1. Never, because your turds got all kinds of bacteria, especially if you eat wildlife out here. You digesting wildlife, it goes through you. You lay an egg or your estimate, and flies lay on it. If you don't bury it, flies will lay on it. Then the flies will come fly on your food and really get you sick. So remember, when you're out in your campsite, when you use the restroom, number two, make sure you go far away and bury your estimate. If you bury it, you don't have to go far away. But if you don't, make sure you go far away from your campsite, because you don't want that fly to land on your food. Take it from Ranger Kooky. I'll see you in a few seconds. All right, a couple things I got in my bag. After I discovered my camping site and I have everything down, I can start building my better shelter home. And the reason why I choose this area, one, it's by water. I have unlimited supply of water. I have a filter system to filter the water. I can take a bath. I have toothpaste. And if I run out of toothpaste, I still got a brush, and I can use ashes from the fire to brush my teeth. So even though I run out of toothbrush or toothpaste, I still got a toothbrush. I can still brush my teeth with the ashes of the fire that I create up there to put base. Then I have, like I said, a limited supply of water. Only thing I'm missing is a good fishing pole or a fishing rod. Now later on, I could bring a fishing pole and just leave it here, because we do catch perch out here. Andrew caught a couple while here. And my friend, another guy, caught some fish out here. We brought him out here. We got some good perch and some, we can catch bass. garfish, bass, catfish, and perch out here in this little water area. I do have food out here. I'm going to survive. Now, only thing I didn't bring is a fishing pole, but I can leave one here for later on use. I might do that during the summer, come out here a couple times, go swimming out here in the bayou. And I can do multiple uses out here. I can use the sand for multiple use. I can build up a shelter and I can build up everything up there with all this. I can get water using that bucket I've left and other equipment that I left here. All right, I think I'm gonna sum this up. I'm Ranger Kooky, and the tags are gonna be linked below who I'm gonna tag, because I'm gonna go through all your videos where I watch and see who I can tag. And the rules are simple. You must leave at midnight, morning, or evening. You must have 7 days of food with you. You must tag 3 people. I said the rules earlier. You might have to go through them. But the rules are simple. You gotta leave. Damn piece of shit. Alright, you gotta leave at 12 o'clock or morning time like I did, or evening. You must carry 7 days of food. You must tag 3 people that have a bug out bag. And you must show using it or showing you how you're going to use it. I can't stay out here for 7 days because I love to. But I'm limited to because of my work. Damn work. So, there you go. I'm going to watch your videos, see what I can tag. Tag 3. And you got to tag 3 also. Alright, I'm Ranger Kooky. I'll see you next video.